Hey, GenderqueerChat, Joe here. Welcome to Sundays with Joe. It's actually like Saturday night at 10 to 12. It's not even Sunday. I'm kind of excited. Okay, this week's topic is, do you think genderqueers have more problems in romantic relationships? Stanley. Oops, give him treats. Sorry about this. You guys are used to me by now, aren't you? Would you date someone who doesn't really understand you, and are you afraid of heights? Okay, do you think genderqueers have more problems in romantic relationships? Now, I can't really speak on behalf of everybody. I can only speak on behalf of me. Have I had problems in romantic relationships? Yes, and I don't think it has anything to do with my genderqueerdom. I really don't. I think the bulk of my problem in romantic relationships is the fact that I'm the child of an alcoholic. I really do believe that is the bulk of the disconnect between, well, if you read up on anything to do with adult children or alcoholism or Al-Anon or anything, a lot of the problem is a tendency to confuse pity with love, and that has been my lifelong battle. I tend to have kind of boyfriends with problems. I pity them. I mistake that for love, and on we go. So the boyfriends that I have had, and I really should touch on what Matt just said. I just watched Matt's video, and I think that was also they were quoting Ricky, which was to do with previously, like before you came out as genderqueer versus after. And I hadn't really thought about that. I haven't dated since I've been out as genderqueer. And I have no desire to. And again, partly because I have no sex drive. And I think that has a lot to do with what I consider to be my asexuality at this point in my life. I don't know that's got nothing to do, again, nothing to do with my genderqueerdom. It's another facet of my personality. I also happen to be asexual. I also happen to be a child of an alcoholic. And those things are impacting my dating life far more than my genderqueerdom ever would. When I did date, or when I had boyfriends, and as you may know, they always were boyfriends, I'm attracted to male-bodied individuals. Men, typically, the types of men who liked me, fell deep and hard. I had a lot of really like nice, good boyfriends who loved me for me. They didn't judge me. They didn't expect me to be something I wasn't. Needless to say, I've never been a girly girl, and the guys who have been with me have never expected me to be a girly girl. So there was always as an acceptance there that I thought. Oh, the neighbors are screaming, screaming children, and it's midnight. But anyway, there was always an acceptance. Sounds like they're right there. Oh. Did you watch our video last week about children? Was it last week about children? The one before? I don't want kids. I can't stand racket. By the way, if you go to my personal channel, Monty Ollie, Montyollie, I just posted a video of my sister and I when we were 10 and 12, like being ridiculous, and I was cringing at how noisy I was at the age of 10. But anyway, I digress. Okay, so did I have problems in those relationships? Yes, but of course they were alcoholic men, or they had other problems. And my gender identity, I think, had stock little to do with it. I really do believe that. I think I have a tendency, because I've been very, very lucky in my life, and I have had a lot of unconditional love, both from my mother, my sister, my friends, and boyfriends, that I consider unconditional love like a prerequisite. I wouldn't be with someone unless they unconditionally loved me. Now, that is going to tie into the next portion, which is, would you date someone who doesn't really understand you? Because the fact is, I would. Actually, I'll touch on that right now. Most people don't understand me, and I don't expect people to ever understand me, and that's okay. I don't think that's a deal breaker for me. Just because, aside from being genderqueer, and aside from being asexual, and aside from being a child of an alcoholic, I'm a lot of other things. I'm an extremely, extremely quirky person with an extremely oddball personality. And I don't just say that. People have told me this repeatedly in my life, and I've strived to be normal. And sometimes I look in the mirror and I think, like, what is it that makes me so strange? Like, why is it everybody tells me I'm so strange? I don't know. I don't know. I just know that I march to the beat of my own accordion, as they say. Actually, I just was cleaning out my closet on the 25th. My sister came over. And we came across a t-shirt she'd made me, because I like that, like, heavy metal. I think I was showing you this last week. Where's that CD? I was listening to Pickin' on Def Leppard. You know, the drummer in Def Leppard has one arm. He lost his arm in a car accident. She made me a t-shirt that said, "Marching to the beat of my own one-arm drummer," which I thought was hilarious. But I've always marched to the beat of my own drummer, my own accordion, my own one-arm drummer. And no one understands me. And that's okay. But if they love me or if they accept me, that's miles above. I mean, that's all you can expect from anybody in life, right? I mean, the only thing I can liken it to is having been raised in a really fundamentalist religion. And I was always completely confounded by people who didn't have a religion or were Protestant or whatever. We were raised Catholic. And I really couldn't understand people's religions. And yet my first few boyfriends, in fact, I don't think I've ever gone out with a Catholic. I think all my life I've gone out with someone who was a different religion than me. And that was okay. I mean, I didn't have to understand their religion to accept them. And they didn't have to understand mine to accept me. And I think gender identity is kind of like religion in that way. It's a very, very personal thing. It doesn't have to make sense to the outside world. You know, people want to be respected. They want their religious beliefs to be respected. Like, they don't want to be mocked for their religious beliefs, and nor do I want to be mocked for my gender identity. So, I mean, there's a certain element of just base respect that's going to have to be there for someone to accept your gender identity, but they don't have to understand it. And in fact, I don't expect most people will. And I don't, maybe that's my age talking, but, you know, I look at someone like Matt and Ricky and I think, okay, to date someone else who's genderqueer, I can't even imagine such a thing. I really can't. Partly because I don't think I'm attracted to that. I'm attracted to distinctly male energy, and male energy that's kind of defined male energy. And so for me, for someone like me, I suspect I will always be with an alpha male type who would, I suspect, would be very, you know, set in their male gender identity. And I wouldn't have to really have to understand or, you know, I wouldn't have to come to terms with that. It just is what it is. And I would hope that they wouldn't have to come to terms with mine. It just is what it is. Further to that, a lot of men, from what I can gather, are just physically, you know, turned on by a body. And I do have a female body, which is, solves a lot of that problem. Do you know what I mean? Like, for the sexual side of things, I mean, for the physical side, for a man to be attracted to the physical me, it's kind of a no-brainer, because a straight man would be attracted to the physical female portion of me. Now, his brain would have to be wrap around my brain, which, like I said, is so quirky in so many other ways that it's, I find that this question is really hard for me, because I cannot separate out my genderqueer identity from all the other portions of my identity that make me who I am. Do I have problems in romantic relationships? Yes. I suspect I will continue to. I don't particularly want a boyfriend. I really don't. My sister and I were just having this conversation, because this was her first Christmas by her single. She's had a boyfriend for, well, she's 41, and she's had a boyfriend since she was 13. So whatever math, 27 years, 28 years. She's never, ever, ever just fucked off on Christmas Day. And we cleaned out my closet. Like I said, we just did nothing. And she said the pressure was off. It was amazing, because she's always had responsibilities or family responsibilities, or somebody had expectations of her, some boyfriend or boyfriend's mother or whatever, excuse me. And so we were just, you know, whatever, going through my closet, cleaning crap out. And she said, I don't think I ever want a boyfriend ever again. And I said, welcome to my world. I mean, it doesn't make you a bad person. It doesn't mean there's anything wrong with you. I suspect someday someone will probably come into my life, just because I happen to believe in astrology. And I have Saturn in the 7th, conjunct my Venus, and this is just, what it indicates is I will probably have love later in life, and that's fine, and probably with somebody much older. And I suspect that will probably be true, but at this point in my life, you know, 2000 and almost 13, age 40, I don't see it. It's not really what I want. I don't have romantic notions. I don't have physical needs. I'm not lonely. I would like to be loved, but I do have a lot of love in my life. So I don't know. I don't know. And would I date someone who doesn't understand me? Yes, I would, because I always have. I probably always will, and I don't think that's the make or break feature in the relationship. I think unconditional love is the feature that I look for, and understanding is nice, but it's not necessary. The bonus question is, are you afraid of heights? I want to say yes. I've done some things in my life. I've done mountain rappelling. I've done the CN Tower. Christina was mentioning the Calgary Tower? Sorry. Yeah, I've done the CN Tower. So long as there's a railing, I'm okay. I've done the Grand Canyon. I don't particularly particularly like standing on the edge of some precipice where there's no railing. But I tend to trust, you know, engineers, engineering. You want to say hi, honey? Come here. Who is this? Do you remember Eli? Oh, hi, sweetie. So Eli will be 18 in January. He's the one who almost died. Still kicking like the rest of us. And that's it for me. Catch you guys next week. Next week is a good one. I think next week is religion, and I'm excited about that topic. See you later. Have a good week.